Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel, Kai Waza with you, and on our journey through my Hawaiian record collection. We're on the letter N, and we're going to pick up where we left off today. We're actually getting, believe it or not, a little bit close to the letter, close to the end of the letter N. I think maybe two videos, I don't know. So, up next we have a couple of albums by two gentlemen who were, I think, pretty well known in the film industry. They did some musical soundtracks. I'm talking about Alfred Newman and Ken Darby, the Alfred Newman Orchestra and the Ken Darby Singers. Ken Darby, also a song composer. And they did a couple of albums of Hawaiian-inspired music. This first one here, The Magic Islands. This one, the little story behind this, apparently Ken Darby took, I'm going to assume, a cruise, because it had to have been like in the late 50s, and it was like for several weeks. Took a cruise or a trip to Hawaii and was very inspired by the music and the sights and the sounds, and upon his return encouraged Alfred Newman, they worked together often, to do the same thing, take a trip to Hawaii and see what he saw, which he did, and they both returned with the inspiration to do an album of Hawaiian-inspired music. Now, I would say it's just easy listening music, but that's not exactly true, because it's kind of almost more tone poems or, you know, theatrical or cinematic music. It's very dramatic, and there's a lot of actually exotic instrumentation in it as well, in addition to sort of your standard orchestra. Western Orchestra and Chorus. It says here, the orchestra contains many musical instruments of Polynesian antiquity. The gourd drums, bamboo pipes, Christmas tree bells, and stone castanets will be heard, some for the first time in any commercial recording. Many of the instruments used by the five percussionists were recreated from prototypes found in the Bishop Museum in Honolulu. So, anyway, it is a gatefold on Decca Records. There's no date on it, but I believe this is the late 50s.
So magic was their love that in the skies above.
And it's a gatefold with that I think is worth taking a closer look at. So let's look at
it.
Songs listings. Instructional with some little language tips there, and everyday Hawaiian words. I should mention also the song, one of the songs on here, Love Song of Kalua, was actually written for the Bird of Paradise movie and featured in the Bird of Paradise movie, and that song actually was very well loved by the islanders, by people in Hawaii, and it kind of has been adopted as a officially really Hawaiian song, and even today, sometimes Hawaiian groups and performers will still sing Love Song of Kalua. It's very well liked here. Now, that was the first one. Apparently they were so inspired, or the first one was so successful, that they decided to continue on. And a few years later, in 1960, they did another album together, this one called Ports of Paradise. Alfred Newman Orchestra, Ken Darby Singers. This also features The up-and-coming singer at the time, a Samoan lady from Samoa and New Zealand, but became known really in the United States as like an easy-listening, loungy jazz singer of note, quite good, Mavis Rivers. And the theme here on this one is not just Hawaii, but it's like a cruise through Polynesia. And there are musical stops in Hawaii, and Tahiti, and New Zealand, and Fiji. And it's not a gatefold, but it has this amazing pull-out, whatever you want to call it, pull-out section. Enchanted Sea, I love the Whispering Wind, Ports of Paradise, of course. And you can actually, I should point out, put it back in the cover on either side. The other side had the ship on it, and if you put it back in this way, you get this picture. So it kind of works either way, right? I like this album, too. They're very dramatic, you know, these two albums, very dramatic. Okay, back to something more on the local scene. This is a Hawaiian record. Is there a date on this? I don't think so. This, I think, is the 80s. The album is called Say That You Love Me Forever. The artist, the Nihau Brothers, featuring Oliver Kelly. Now, I do want to point out, because there is some confusion sometimes amongst people that live here, it is Nihau, with one I, Nihau, not Ni'ihau, not the island Ni'ihau. It's the Nihau Brothers and Oliver Kelly. This album, you know, fairly popular. Anything with Oliver Kelly locally would achieve some level of popularity here. I did for hours since I met you. I should add, Purple Raindrops is a huge hit off of here. I like the song Lolotina. Now, I should say it's a marijuana song, and I don't, you know, normally I just don't like Pacololo marijuana songs. It's just kind of stupid to me, whatever. I'm just not into it. But I just like that song. I mean, they're just reciting the names of different names of marijuana, but the song, it's like, it's cute. I like the song. Anyway, oh, that's Oliver Kelly there. And the Nihau Brothers. Now, speaking of the island of Ni'ihau, here's an album that is using that name, Ni'ihau, Hawaii. And these three musicians on this album, recording together, Nedward and Letward Kapana and Bernard Kamala, we've seen them before. They've all been in other groups in various combinations. There they are. And this album is a project of theirs together in that grassroots Hawaiian style. Of them you might remember on this album that we just featured. Let's see, is there a date on this? 1980. Pumehana Records. Okay, well, that's it for today. Let me just put this back in here. I hope you enjoyed that.